In the vast universe of jazz, there's one album that resonates like a timeless echo, a masterpiece that transcends eras. Ever heard a tune so captivating it felt like the musicians were playing live in your basement? Today, we're taking a deep dive into Grant Green's classic album Idle Moments. Recorded at the famous Van Gelder studio in November of 1963, this album captures a pivotal moment in jazz history. It's a snapshot of a golden era in jazz, and as we dive in, you'll feel the passion and artistry that made this record an enduring classic. So grab you a cup of tea, sit back, relax, and enjoy our video. But before you do this, please smash that like button, ring that notification bell, and subscribe to our channel to stay up to date on the latest album releases and reviews of classic albums like Idle Moments. This album is a classic in the Music Matters Jazz SRX series and mastered by Kevin Gray at his Coherent Audio Studio from the original analog tapes. It was then pressed at RTI on a special proprietary formula called Silent Running Experience, or SRX for short. This is the quietest vinyl I've ever heard. This SRX reissue immerses listeners into a sonic realm of unmatched clarity. From the punchy bass lines of Bob Cranshaw to the warm tones of Joe Henderson's tenor, every note is a revelation. The super quietness in the vinyl allows you to concentrate more on the music and hear the separation and detail of all the instruments. With Green coming straight out of the left speaker and Henderson coming out of the right speaker, it creates an illusion of a live performance right here in my basement. It's an incredible experience when you listen to anything from the SRX series. And now for the music. The title track, Idle Moments, is a slow-burning masterpiece. Green's melodic solos are complemented by Henderson's tenor interludes, while Pearson's piano provides a harmonious backdrop. The piece unfolds gradually, drawing listeners into its intimate embrace with each note, creating an atmosphere of contemplation and serenity. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Tune Gene de Fleur simply uplifts any mood. With Green's fluidity, Henderson's expressive sax, and Pearson's rhythmic sequences, it's jazz in its purest form. From its opening notes to its vibrant crescendo, the tune encapsulates the joy and spontaneity that makes jazz such a uniquely captivating genre. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Then comes Django, a tribute to the legendary guitarist Django Reinhardt. Each note and chord are a homage and celebration to this jazz giant. The track resonates with the spirit and innovation that Django brought to the world of jazz guitar. The musicians pour their respect and admiration into every measure, crafting a piece that beautifully echoes Reinhardt's enduring influence. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Thank you. Now for the maestros behind this classic. Grant Green, with no formal training, showcased a natural talent and passion for the guitar that set him apart from his contemporaries. His unique approach to melodies and chord progressions was a testament to his natural prowess. This self-taught journey led him to develop a signature style that became instantly recognizable in the jazz world. Joe Henderson's tenor brought a distinctive voice to the session, elevating its sonic landscape. His expressive solos and interludes, especially on tracks like Idle Moments and Jean de Fleur, showcased his virtuosity. Henderson's contributions not only complemented Green's guitar, but also became a defining and unforgettable element of the album's overall sound. Duke Pearson's piano work served as a harmonious foundation, adding depth and structure to the album's compositions. His rhythmic sequences and melodic touches provided a perfect counterpoint to Green's guitar and Henderson's saxophone. Pearson's role both as a musician and as an arranger was instrumental in shaping the cohesive and soulful sound of the record. Bobby Hutcherson's vibraphone brought a distinctive and shimmering touch. His skillful play, particularly in tracks like Django, added a delicate layer perfectly blending with the album's overall mood and rhythm. Bob Cranshaw's bass playing anchored the group with its deep resonant tones. His ability to intertwine rhythmically with the other instruments gave the album a cohesive and warm foundation. Al Harewood's drumming provided the rhythmic heartbeat, driving the tempo and dynamics of each track. His subtle yet precise touches complemented the band, adding depth and movement to the album's overall sound. While the Blue Note Classic Vinyl Series offers a commendable experience, the SRX version stands a class apart. Its overall sound quality with its clarity and depth is an audiophile's dream. But here's the catch. The SRX version, which is now a collector's item, is out of print. With Music Matters Jazz no longer in business, this edition has become a valued treasure. Today, Idle Moments is more than an album. It's a legacy and an inspiration, a testament to jazz's timeless allure. It's a must-have for any serious jazz collector, old or new. If this deep dive resonated with you, please smash that like button, ring the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel to join us for more journeys into the world of jazz. Thank you for tuning into my channel. Until next time, keep the jazz alive and the record spinning. Bye for now.